From the very beginning, man has been a hunter. And the instinct to hunt is still alive. As we pursue our quarry, the dramas of life and death unfold. The natural cycle of life is driven by those who pursue. Even so, the Earth's great creatures are well aware of man's quest. Their keen ability to elude predation has evolved through time, giving the hunter a worthy quarry. And the hunted know that the stakes are high.
Yes! Oh, yes!
I ain't wearing nothing but a loincloth and feathers in my hair from now on. Awesome freaking money.
This is the story of the hunter. And his relentless pursuit. Welcome to this edition of Relentless Pursuit. Today I'm bow hunting predators in Canada and Montana.
That's strange. There's about a 2,000-pound bull cow laying over here in this wheat field about a mile up the ravine from us. Surrounding the bull is six coyotes. They don't have a chance of killing him, but why they're messing with him like that, I don't know. But that's probably the way they hunt and kill other animals. Wind's in my face. We're going to sneak down along this ravine. I'm going to close in about a quarter mile from them and call to them. There's no wind today, so they will hear me real well.
We'll be hunting with sundown outfitting. The coyote population, like other game animals, must be managed. Bow hunting is an unusual way to go about killing predators. But I enjoy calling in bow hunting, for the bow is quiet, which often affords me more than one shot. I closed in to within 100 yards of the coyotes. The mouse squeak is by far my best call, so I needed to be close. However, in this case, it worked almost too well, for all five coyotes came at us from different directions. My cameraman was completely confused as to which one to film. Shots will range from 10 to 80 yards, and these coyotes are at the extreme. They're trying to downwind me, and as the first one does, I realize there's no time, I'm going to have to take the shot. The first shot glances off the coyote's head. The second shot misses completely. The third scores, and the last shot merely adds insult to injury.
That was pretty unique. Kept calling them coyotes, and they're like other big game animals like elk and so forth. If you don't get in close on them sometimes, if they're lazy, I bet them dogs have been eating all night, so they didn't want to come in when I was using my predator call down a quarter mile. We belly crawled into 100 yards, and I mouse squeaked them right up to us and shot, gave the first one a real nice haircut. So if you ever kill a coyote that has a V down the forehead, no hair right there, that'd be my signature. But then I killed the second one, so. It was pretty exciting. I love hunting predators, and we're just getting started. So, come along, let's hit the next patch of timber.
From a distance, I've spotted another coyote feeding in a meadow. And once again, we've low crawled within calling distance. He hears the call and commits. the last moment, the coyote realizes his mistake and runs for cover. But it's too late, for the arrow is on its way and meets its mark. Death comes quickly.
That was awesome. Big, beautiful coyote. Oh, I finished him with a squeak, but I didn't get to kill him standing looking at me. I wanted to drive one right through him, but he hit my way. Oh, there's another one on the ridge, Mike. Two of them. He's down, he's down. Swing your camera up there and get him. He's down, slowly, slowly. Anyway, I busted him on the run. These coyotes get down in the drainage. I'll go pick up the other dead one. And then we'll go call them in and slock one of them. Another beautiful coyote. All right. We got those other coyotes on the ridge. They have no clue what's in store for them. We're gonna sneak down this drainage, try to find a hole to call to them, call another one in.
I made one short call, and here they came. The first coyote took an arrow through the ribs. And the second retreated just in time.
Well, there's another fine coyote. I'll tell you what, these coyotes up here are amazing. This is just a pup for Alberta, and you can see they are big animals. They get pretty good size. This would be a big male back home, and you would never, very rarely see a coyote this size down in Texas or Oklahoma or something. So, further north you get, the bigger the animals get, and the coyote's proof of it. Well, I got a good bait spot here for my magpie hunting. I'm gonna put this coyote out here. He's one of the Magpie is one of the few birds that will actually eat a coyote, so put him out here and come back tomorrow and I'll probably get some action. Hope you're enjoying Relentless Pursuit. Stick with us. We'll be back with more action.
Now, magpies are quite a trophy if you can take one with a bow. They're lightning fast and as keen-eyed as any bird I've ever encountered. Mikey and I have been sitting here for about 2 hours waiting on a magpie. And I missed. Thought I got him in the butt, but I think I missed. Hurt my feelings.
At least your hat looks good.
Yes, it does.
Got him.
Now I'm no quitter. I return the next day with a vengeance. This bird is now in my trophy room.
Headshot. My favorite. Quick and clean. Sass lips is dead. There are hundreds of magpies in Alberta, and I guess locals are just disgusted with them. They're
since the magpie population has escalated, the songbird population has just went to crap up here because these guys are really good at finding the nest, running the bird off and eating the eggs. So they're kind of like our cowbird at home. But I'm out of arrows, and I got more birds on the bait.
Once again, I've spotted three coyotes and are moving in on them. This time, I'll try to sneak up close enough for a shot without ever calling. They're resting on the crest of a ridge, and I'm now at 15 yards. With a quick squeak of a mouse, one stands up, only to find that a mouse is now another predator. Quickly, I release, and the shot hits home. The second dog is now confused. He can't figure why the one ran off while there's still a mouse squeaking. It's time to take my shot.
Got him.
The shot was a bit low.
Maybe I didn't. Maybe I was low.
Gotta find him. Where'd the other one go? They're both behind the same
spot. He's already dead on the ridge.
With another coyote hunt successfully behind me, I'm back for the birds. A crow is quite a trophy as well to take with a bow. That evening, I was back in my blind with a choice on the menu. Should it be a crow or a magpie? I went for the crow, which at the time I assumed was a young raven. When we return, a predator has made its kill. As a hunter, there are few moments that raise the heart rate more than those of an approaching predator with a thirst for blood. After a short calling sequence, I noticed I was being watched. This was no coyote, nor was it a bobcat. An adult lion, a killer by most standards, capable of taking down an 800-pound bull elk. His eyes were now fixed to mine. Squared off at 20 yards, both he and I held our ground. The first to run would likely be the first to die. So the stare down continued. With ears back and a wrinkled face, then a low growl, he sent his message that he was not here to play. It was obvious by this point that he knew I was human. Ever so slowly, I eased closer, all the while looking for an area to thread the arrow. Behind a wall of brush, he maintained his stare. At this range, a charging headshot will be my only option if he so chooses. Finally, at 10 yards, the standoff is over. The big cat has chosen his only good exit. He's facing directly away from me, not giving me a good shot at his vitals. I try to get the huge cat to turn and give me just one small hole to thread the arrow into his heart. And it finally does. But at that moment, I hear the heart-wrenching words of my cameraman. Don't shoot. The camera battery has died. It's not every day that you walk up on a mountain lion that's got his ears laid back staring at you hoping you get closer. At least that was my impression of the whole encounter. And Mike and I are a little hoping that we could get just any predator to come in, and then we got done calling and didn't go 50 yards up the hill, and there's this lion looking at us with his ears back. I moved in within 15 yards of him. He never did give up ground. We just figured out why. If you look down here, we haven't uncovered it yet, but here's something amazing. If you look on the ground here, you'll see something that's covered up. It's a nice little mound. And look here. I'm sure most of you know what that is. But that's why this lion wasn't giving up his ground. You might step back a little bit, might get a little more overall. Back up a little. Oh, looky there. Amazing. That's amazing. He's killed this beaver, and this is a big beaver, I can tell you right now. This is a 45-pound beaver. Just ate the head and the back of the neck completely out of it. It's a fresh kill. And you can see that there's not another bite on this anymore, unless he's got it. No. The only place that there's even a wound on this beaver is right in the back of the neck. He broke his neck, obviously, and then went ahead and ate 5 or 6 pounds of meat and then covered up his kill. I highly doubt he'll be back after our encounter, but it's possible. At any rate, here we are on a wild encounter with one of the world's top predators. There's others waiting. I've got my call. It still works. We got a fresh battery in, so. That was an encounter, one I will always remember the rest of my life. And I think Mike and I are going to go back to camp, change our underwear, and then we'll be back to hunt more predators. Stay with us right here with Relentless Pursuit, America's #1 bow hunting show.